Hi, this is Carl Benjamin, and this is my top 10 UK artists with Made in the UK. My thought process behind picking my top 10 was massively based on how they've influenced me. So a lot of my artists that I'm picking haven't released anything that I'm really listening to right now. But when it comes to like my past and everything, you know, they pushed me in different sounds in different ways that I didn't think I'd be pushed and stuff. So it's a mixture of like who I'm listening to right now, UK wise, and who has influenced me like prior, if that makes any sense. So in at number 10 is Muramasa. Muramasa, yeah, he was huge. I'm not a producer per se, but when I listened to his tunes and everything, yeah, back in like 2017, it blew my mind. I was literally walking down the street with such a bop on my shoulders and stuff, and he was like just killing the game. It was crazy. He was doing bits and just from like his bedroom and stuff. It's just, yeah, it was crazy. Yeah, my favorite tune from Muramasa was Lovesick back in the day. And then a quick second under that was Firefly that he had with Neo. That was such a bop. That was crazy. He was huge for me. Like he got me listening to production, you know, if that makes any sense. The instrumental side of everything. He really forced my brain to tune into the different sounds that could be made within music and everything. And yeah, I loved Muramasa. He was a big favorite artist for me back in 2017. It's a good year. In at number 9, we have Dave. Yeah, Dave and Psychodrama. That was a big album for me. My favorite song off of Psychodrama was Location, as you can probably flip and guess and everything. It was huge. And it was just a bop. Songwriting wise, it was crazy. Feature was crazy. Production was crazy. Energy was crazy. But what really like tied my heart into that album was what track was it called? Leslie? Leslie with that whole monologue about that woman and her life and everything. Wow. Wow. I love storytelling in music. Like I love Kendrick Lamar's like Section 80 because of his storytelling, and artists that can properly like hook you in and tell a story and everything. That's big flex for me, being able to do that and still make a bop and everything. So Dave killed it. So coming in at number 8 is Sade. Sade, she's just a legend, man. She's crazy. Like, it's not that I know and love like a huge amount of her songs. Like, you put on a Sade song and I can probably promise you I'm gonna love it. But the one song that like jumps out at me is It a Crime? And wow, her voice sounds crazy on it. Like, I'm really trying to, I have that, like, every once in a while when I go to a session, that song plays in my head, like, just, like, naturally. I won't listen to it or anything. I wouldn't have listened to it for, like, God knows how long, but that song just, like, lives rent-free in my head, like, 100%. It's crazy. It's like, is it a crime? Do-do-do. And she falls into this, just this, like, such an interesting groove with it out of the top line and everything. And yeah, it's crazy. Like little bits like that production wise, like vocally playing with the track at the same time, that's crack to me. Yeah, that's like a really, really, that's a really good sound to my ears, if that makes any sense. Yeah, it's crazy. Sade. So at number 7, we have Sampha. Sampha is one of my favorite songwriters. It's so... Okay, when did I discover Sampha? When did I discover Sampha for myself? It was after a Drake album, but I can't remember what Drake album it was, and I had no idea who Sampha was. Is it okay that I can't give like a set time or place when I've really... Okay, that's great, because I cannot remember, but all I remember is how hard like the song Nobody Knows Me Like My Piano hit me, or Timmy's Prayer hit me. Like the production and vocal in there, it's crazy. And then the movements that he's actually made globally and everything, working with Solange, working with Drake, working with like so many people, you know, and just like having that reach as a UK artist and everything. And in the field that he does, like creates in his genre or his box or wherever he likes to place himself, and then spreads himself out across all the rest of these genres and still makes it work. That blows my mind. Yeah, he's very, very talented. I'd love to meet him one day. Sampha, always been a big inspiration of mine. So at number 6, we have Quabs. Corb's completely changed the way I write music, the way I sing and everything, to be honest with you. He was very, because I had just moved to university, and I think it was 2017 again. Corb's released his album, and one song off of that album is Perfect Ruin. Perfect Ruin was such a sad song to me, but like, it's one of those ones where if you're in the mood for it, you can like stand there and just belt this song from your gut like 20 times a day and it would still slap, because it's just a beautifully written song about his struggle and everything. And yeah, being able to put that pain that he feels and the hurt that he was going through into words and everything is, it's insane. Yeah, I remember I missed the chance to go see him at this gig in Brighton one time, and I was so pissed. Like, half of my friends went and I didn't get to go. That really sucked. Yeah. But then I met him at a Neo gig, which was really sick, to be fair. I completely forgot about that. Five Sam Wise. Oh, okay. Five Sam Wise. Okay. Sam Wise blew my mind when he released Sorry You Were Saying in 2019 to the artwork, like, of him just like with the little the soap bar made out of his head. That was huge for me. That was a big inspiration as to where my own EP artwork came from and everything, you know, just like the sculpture of the head and stuff. And that was one reference that I really appreciated and saw, and I was like, yeah, this is fucking sick. But yeah, it's just of him like lowering this like soap bar of his own head into this bar. And it's just a vibe. But yeah, multiple songs off of that. What was my favorite song off of that? Town Down was a vibe. Big vibe. Like, you play that and I'm going crazy. I'm like losing all of my shit. And yeah, you won't hear from me for a few hours. I've never seen Sam Wise live, but I would love to. Yeah, I've since 2019, and hearing his vibe and everything, and just seeing him as a character and with the energy that he holds. Yeah, I'd love to see Sam Wise live. That'd be a mood and a half. And number four, we have Jack James. I'm not gonna lie, Jack James is a very recent one for me. Jack James he's obviously been around and in the UK game for a while now, but there was one song that came on in a playlist. I cannot remember what the playlist was, but yeah, his music came on. It was No Drama, and yeah, it was crazy. Like the dances that he had in the video and the complete like 90s R&B feel that he had within the video and the actual song itself. Like, he vocally, he took from More Than a Woman, from, what was that? Is that Aaliyah? And yeah, it's crazy. He just worked it like crazy into the actual flow of the song and everything. And yeah, Jack James is a recent one for me, but he's doing bits when it comes to R&B right now. It's really, really, really refreshing and nice to hear. At number three is Scarlett Fletcher. I think she goes by Scarlett Faye on like streaming sites and everything. So if you want to find her, she's under in Spotify and Apple Music and stuff like that as Scarlett Faye. And yeah, she is actually somebody that I met. She was the first friend that I made when I moved down to Brighton. So we were on the same course and everything, same music course. And her voice is just incredible. Her voice is insane. And she is really, really, really doing bits. So like, one of my favorite songs of hers, she hasn't got a massive collection of songs out right now, but one of my favorite songs of hers is Won't You. And I just believe the song itself and the switch up that the actual song holds from the chorus to the verse to be like one of the nicest switched ups within a song that I've heard in a very long time. Yeah, and she's so nice. She's a really great person. So when you're listening to her music and everything, you know that she's a really nice person. It just kind of like amplifies like the music itself for me. But yeah, Scarlett Faye, she's really, really talented. To Bobby Johnson. Bobby Johnson is one of, and I say this with my whole chest, is one of my favorite UK rappers right now. And I think she's going to hold that place for a very long time. Bobby Johnson, she hails from South, so in Brighton area as well, and she's also a friend of mine. And I don't want you to think that this list is biased. I actually really, really love these artists and everything. I'm not just picking them because of my friends, like, I promise. But yeah, if you haven't checked out Bobbi Johnson, I definitely recommend it. Like, she works a lot with, she was recently recommended on, I think, BBC Radio 1 by Rag and Bone Man. And she does a lot of work with him and everything. And yeah, she's just, she's going to be big, man. I think she's going to be absolutely huge. She's got her own flow, her own sound, her own decorum, her own swagger about her. And she's just wavy, man. She's wavy. She sits in a pocket. She's wavy. She jumps on a little melody. She's wavy. She's just got a bop about her. And yeah, I'd love to see more from her and more exposure on her right now, personally. But yeah, she's incredible. And at number one, we have Rachel Chinoriri. I first discovered Rachel Chinoriri when I originally started making my own solo stuff. Yeah, I actually met her because she was working with some of the producers that I was working with around that time. And she's just incredible. Like, her songwriting is so good. It's so deep, so delicate, so well worded that it will literally like leave you like, what the hell? Like, how did you put these feelings into words and everything? Like, how have you arranged this story and everything? And like, yeah, so the first song that I ever realized of hers was So My Darling. And yeah, it's just this beautiful song about loving. And it could be like, I went to go see her at a gig this one time, and she explained it and everything, and she was just like, this is a song about love and just like feeling love, not necessarily, oh, I'm in love with you, blah 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 blah, but it was like, oh, you feel the love for like your friends, your mum, your auntie. And it's just a song about love, and I've never heard anybody put it into words like she has in that song, and it blew my mind. I've been Carl. And this has been my top UK artist with Made in the UK. Thank you for watching. Said you're coming.